Hello and welcome back. This time I want to talk about some graphical equalizers that I bought and the reasons why I bought them. When we get older, our hearing will degrade. And lately, due to the disease I have, my hearing is a bit of a problem. I am afraid that I can't hear any high-pitched noises anymore. So, if I make a video, there could be some problems with background noise. So the solution could be some graphical analyzer to see if there are some noises that I couldn't hear. So I looked on the internet and came across this thing. It's a graphical equalizer that you have to build yourself. So I ordered one from a webshop and waited a couple of days. Here it is in all its glory. And everything is included in the kit, except for solder or some type of casing to put it in when it's done. Some resistors. The back main board. Everything is already drawn out for you. And this is the display. It's well packed. Those are small. The first thing is to solder the microchip socket on the board. And next all the resistors and the small wire jumpers. And it's done. I even made a case for it. Well, a case. Let's just say it will protect the electronics. If you would build your own amplifier, you could use those as VU meters. So this is the casing I built. When this was filmed, I didn't have a 3D printer yet. So, a couple of days later, I went online again to check for casings, and guess what I found? Yep, another equalizer, and this time with a color screen and two stereo inputs. I wish I found this earlier. But hey, what do you do? Well, order it, of course. So, all the way from Bulgaria, here it is, in all its mighty glory. Well, the packaging looks good. And there's a personal message. That's a nice touch. And on its website, there are software updates, some setup files. They even have different models with OLED screen or LCD screen, and in monochrome or color. So very nice indeed. And here is the unit. It's delivered without a case, but you can print it yourself or you can order one online. Oh, this looks nice. Just look at that big touchscreen. Wow. The print is designed by him, I think. It's very well designed. There is a SD card holder on the board and the pin connectors on the side for your stereo inputs and a USB connector for the power source. This is the size, right next to the other one. And as you can see, there is a lot of difference. Not only is the screen size bigger, it is also a touchscreen. The pricing of these two is almost the same, but there could be some difference between the costs to deliver it to your home. The visible area is much smaller than the screen size. The response of the screen is very slow, and honestly, I didn't even bother to hook it up. And this is the STL file found on the website for the other one, so you can print the casing yourself. And this is not bad at all. Look at it. Marvelous. It's compact enough to fit anywhere, and yet the screen is highly visible and it is very rich in colors. Warning, turn off your headphones or turn it down a bit. There will be some high-pitched notes. So the frequency is perfectly visible on emitters. It will give you a very nice indication of what is happening in the audio source. This is a spatial audio test, just to see if left is really left and right is really right. It is very good indeed. The complete spectrum is visible, from the high-pitched notes to the bass. Very nice. The screen looks even better in person. Through this camera, there is a rasterizing effect, and you don't see that in person. There are a couple of modes to toggle through, and each one has a different palette. In the menu, you can control all the inputs. The gain for this preset is a bit too high, but you could turn it down a little bit if you wanted to. Waveforms, master outputs, everything is possible. The gain on this one is also a little bit too high. This is like a waveform. They even have some old VU meters. Look at them. Gorgeous. Just imagine if you build this in your own power amplifier. What a great look it would be. There are so much settings you can adjust. This is the gain, the input, from channel A and B. And you can preset it as you need it. So overall, I'm very satisfied with my setup. I really like how portable it is and how much you can see on the screen in one blink of an eye. I think this device will help me in the future. Also in the future, I will print out a nice case for this power amplifier. And maybe in the future I will get a nice pair of speakers. For the time being, this is good enough. So thanks for watching, and if you're interested, please follow the links down below.